I'm sure you've seen these headlines and seen videos of, mass exodus from California, and Californians are fleeing the state, and Texas and Idaho and Nevada and Florida are all being overrun with Californians. Now, obviously, there's more people moving to those states than in a typical year. I mean, you take in factors like the ability to work from home, retired people that are cashing out. I mean, that's been so many of my seller clients over the last 7 years is selling and following family to wherever they ended up. But cost of living, I mean, these are all contributing factors. But researchers analyzed credit bureau data to figure out where did Californians move in 2020. And what they found was the majority of people are moving within the state. Now, people are leaving San Francisco specifically to be sure. I mean, I looked to see the MLS data of how many active listings there were on the market in 2020. It was the equivalent of how many properties were on the market in 2010, which was the peak of the financial crisis for San Francisco when you had just this glut of foreclosures and people trying to get out of their properties, and so many homes were on the market during that time. Now, surprisingly, that hasn't impacted their price as much. Actually, overall prices in San Francisco were up about 1.8% last year. I mean, the prices rose even more for single-family homes. It was the townhouse and condo market that really held that back. So for these people that are fleeing San Francisco specifically, where are they going? So according to the San Francisco Chronicle, the top five destinations of people leaving San Francisco was number one, Alameda, number two, San Mateo, number three, Marin County, then Santa Clara County, and Sonoma County. So when people are leaving San Francisco, they're just relocating to some other spot around the bay. And the same article listed the top 15 locations, all of which are in California. And with those top five destinations being right around the Bay Area, it has had a very interesting effect on our housing market. I have a client in Sunnyvale, where in the same neighborhood that I grew up, and she lives in LA and called me saying, like, I'm reading all these articles, like people are fleeing the Bay Area. The prices must be getting hammered. And I was like, it's about $300,000 price difference in the opposite direction. The median sales price for a single-family home in Santa Clara County in December was $1,355,000. For the first half of March, so far the median sales price is $1,650,000. Now the townhouse and condo market, I mean, it's still appreciated 7%, but not quite to the extent that single-family homes did. And I think the big contributing factors to that are people are moving out of the city into the suburbs, and they figured, well, if I'm going to have to shelter in place or work from home, I want a backyard and I want space from my neighbors. And these have all contributed to people kind of more focusing on single-family homes and really driving up those prices. But as people come back to work over the next probably 2 to 3 years, I think that market is going to kick in as well. Now, the reason I wanted to address that kind of misconception of people fleeing the area is that I have clients who are like, well, if everyone is really fleeing the Bay Area, then why are there 25 offers on the house that we just submitted an offer on, and why did we get outbid by $500,000? And the answer is, it's low inventory, it's low interest rates, it's people with a lot of cash because of stocks that they've sold, and this has all combined to just create this firestorm of competition in really all the Bay Area counties aside from San Francisco. So hopefully that gives a little bit more context on some of these articles that, yeah, people are moving. Some are leaving California, but the majority are staying in California. And honestly, the people that can afford to be in the Bay Area in the first place are still looking for property. And with limited inventory, that has just created, I think, the most competitive seller's market that we have ever had.